Hello everyone, it's Valerie. Today I'm doing some foraging in the woods for some wild plants. And today is the perfect day for doing that because it's been raining for 2 days and everything has been had a little bit of a wash. It's nice and lush out today. This looks like a beautiful spot, actually. I'm not only looking for wild plants, but I'm also looking for mushrooms. So everything has had a chance to get nice and lush lately because of the weather. And it's had a good wash off. And now it's a hot sunny day, so everything's been dried off since this morning, and it's just a perfect day to collect some greens. I want to dry them and for making some nice healthy drinks and adding to my foods. So we're also checking for mushrooms. So like I said, it's a perfect day for this. Got a nice foxglove specimen here. Also going to be checking some areas that have been logged. You know, we're in British Columbia, Canada, and there's a lot of logging that goes on here. But one of the good things about logging, and I'm not at all for the way that they log. I'm not in agreement with the practices. I understand it, I get it. But I don't like the way that they do it. I think it really destroys a lot of the nature. But I do understand why they do what they do. I just don't agree with it. But as long as these companies are owned by giant corporations, they're going to do the practices that make the most money. As you can see here, it's very lush in here, isn't it? I should be able to gather lots of greens. But one of the things that happens when they clear cut is having their big machinery, their bulldozers and their skidders going into the areas. It churns up the soil and brings a lot of the seeds out in the open, and then with our winter and spring rains, a lot of these seeds germinate, and the edges of these forested areas become very, very full of green plants that are great for harvesting. Another foxglove there. I'll get a close-up of him. Well, that is one good thing about it. They used to go, oh, nettles. That's going to be the, oh, I didn't bring gloves. That's okay. I can still harvest it. So that's one of the good things about the way that they do the clear cutting is it does cause all of these plants to sprout, which are great for harvesting. They used to spray herbicides in it, and then they would do their planting, their tree planting, and then after the trees are planted and they've grown up a bit, then they would go and spray more herbicides. But they don't do that anymore because they found out that just having people walk through and do foraging and collect salal and mushrooms and berries and what have you, that it does more for the woods than actually spraying the herbicides. And all the herbicides did was make blind animals and just destroy the ecology of the woods. So that stinging nettle is pretty eaten up by bugs, but there's some good stuff in there. I'm going to wander around a bit more and see if there's some healthier stinging nettles. So I probably won't do much talking on the remaining of this video. I'm just going to let you enjoy what I'm doing, and I'll be putting up across the screen what it is that I'm picking at the time so you can see it for yourself. Just spotted something. I'm not going to take it, but I will show you. It's just too beautiful to take. Look at that giant fungus. Huge! And there's my hand. You can see how big that is. It's huge. Get underneath it. So I'm just in this new section to do some foraging. It's a place where I found some wild mint and water plantain last year. But just when I got down to the bottom of the hill, see, there's this, it's actually a power line. But way down over there, there's a marsh. That's where I wanted to go to, but right down in, when I got down right about in here, there was something crashing in the bush over here. So I come up this hill where I have a bit of a vantage point to see what, if anything, comes out. Could be a dog, because we're not too far from civilization. Could be a deer, although usually deer aren't that noisy when they walk through the bush. So, I don't know. Could be a human. I'm gonna sit here for a while and just have some coffee and listen and see if anything comes out of those woods. Maybe we'll get a good shot of a bear. This is one of the roads. Look at this. Beautiful red clover specimens. And then right behind it, more garbage. Seriously? Don't understand people. Sometimes I just don't understand people. I went over, I decided in that other spot to just go back to the car because I could smell something pretty bad in the other location. I don't know whether it was the bear or just something that had died. I don't know. And really far away from the car. I don't have bear spray. I do have a couple of things on me that's a bit of a deterrent, but not very useful. Oh, look. Some plantain right beside it. This is your more common plantain. I'm going to be fighting with the bees with this clover, I know it. They're all over this bush. They're not going to like me. Take too many. Usually I just pick a few things off of one bush and carry on to the next one. another type of plantain. Nice truck drop. No bears, only dog. Although that doesn't look like a dog. That looks like a bear. Oh, look, it's a puppy. A puppy. Weird, out here. Ooh, bees like this plant too, so I'll just take a few. Oh, there's a fireweed, small one. There we go. Oh, that's good. Thought they'd all be finished by now. Ouch. scared away a bee. Fireweed that's a little older. This teeny tiny little bee flowers. What are they? Well, it looks like forget-me-nots. See if I can get a good shot. What mess people leave, honestly. Good place to forage. It has a wide variety of plants. I might come back and get some of these thistle once they flower. Oh my goodness. Seriously? Just breaks my heart, you know. This is why they block off the roads, because idiots like this, they ruin it for everybody else. It's even up in there. Wow. Okay, I'm going to seriously do some picking now. Okay, that's my bag. Pretty full. I got another one in the car. Almost full. That's going to be about all my dehydrator can handle for today. Or for the next few days, anyways. It'll be busy. I'll be busy drying lots of things around the house. Yummy.